Hello there. This is my first foray into making a video on an astrophotography topic. And the reason I'm doing it is because I have been asked how I have been removing stars from an image and then adding them back in after editing the nebula. So to not blow out the stars so much and to be able to edit the stars and the nebula separately. First, big shout out to this video, StarXTerminator and Better Star Removal than Starnet Plus Plus by Delta Astrophotography, who goes through this same process and a little bit of editing. Well, but
Hi,
a
I'm
really
Walt.
good
This is Delta
video
Astrophotography.
on
When you're
the
processing your
comparing both Starnet Plus and StarXTerminator. I personally use StarXTerminator. So you can use this method with StarNet Plus, but I want to take you from the beginning. And this is a very typical image if you use Photoshop and Deep Sky Stacker. The first thing you're going to want to do is crop a little bit. Don't have to crop too much. Then you're going to change the image 16 bits. Exposure and gamma. Boom. What I like to do is create another layer, a duplicate layer. This is where I just kind of do my initial levels. Bring shadows all the way down. Bring the highlights a little bit up so it kind of covers to the line a little bit. Okay. And from here, I create threshold adjustment layer. So I can begin color balance. I'll do that is use the eyedropper tool, the color sample, 5x5 average. Zoom in here. So there's no stars. This image here, there is going to be a lot of nebulosity. The chances are I'm hitting nebulosity here. But hopefully, based upon these numbers up here, which they're both so far pretty straightforward, this one's a little bit lower. Won't be too bad. Next thing I do, the slide to the highlights a little bit. Want to find a bright star. We have one down here. Get to the center. Go to 27, 244, 242. There we go. Delete my threshold layer. I go back to levels. What I'm doing here, instead of doing it at RGB, go to each individual channel. Now, since I used an L enhance filter on this image, a red channel is already going to be all the way over toward the shadow or to the black point. But I need to bring this number up here up the what I want to do is bring it to 248. Go to green, bring this up just a little bit to 240. Mouse control's a little off today. Let's just use 7.3 here. Go to blue, same thing. Down 7, okay. Okay, I learned this technique from Trevor Jones at Astro Backyard. Get your initial color balance. It works well for me. And here. So from here, next thing I want to do, light stretch. We can do it by curves, or we can do it by levels. You can experiment with both. Do it by levels here for this example. Go. And then from here, what I like to do is do a slight gradient pass are C-Astro's radiant exterminator. Coarse and low. And you can experiment with balancing the background color. For this tutorial, we're going to do it. Good to go. See our histogram. Pretty straight and narrow. Whatever. From here, we'll create another layer. Call this starless. And what I would do is I would run StarXTerminator. Luckily, I've already done it over here. Because it takes a few minutes. And I don't want this video to be long. Now we have our starless layer from our small stretch. What I'm going to do is I'm going to uncheck this. See, there's a stars starless layer. I'm going to duplicate this layer underneath starless. I'm going to go up to image, plot image. The layer I want to use is starless. I want to subtract. I want my offset to be 2. Boom. Now we have a star layer and a starless layer. You can do this with Starnet++. What you're going to do is once you get your starless image from Starnet, you're going to want to add that in as your starless layer over here. Do the same thing with the apply image and subtract. And there you have your star layer. From here, you can do a lot of different things. You use astronomy tools actions, make your star smaller. You can go into camera raw filter, something I like to do. And just go down to my color mixer and see where I have all these red stars and they're kind of bloated looking. But they're a little too red, a little too orange. Move my saturation down a little bit. Let's say 40 on red, 30 on orange. See, makes a difference. There's still a red tinge there, but it's not nearly as overpowering. Okay. And from here, I might run, make star smaller. I might do highlights. Color range, select these stars, there, let modify, span by 2 pixels, we go down to filter, other, minimum, make sure we have roundness select, hit OK, kind of the same thing that make stars smaller does, a little bit quicker, but not necessarily as efficient. I like the make stars smaller a little bit better, but I'm also lazy. I'm going to duplicate the layer. And what we're going to do is we're going to put this layer on top. So our star layer, our star mask, whatever we want to call it, is on top of our starless mask layer here. Now all we're going to do is go to blend mode. And we're going to hit linear dodge add. And now we have our stars back on top of starless thing. The one thing I want to show you, this was our original. This is our starless. This is with our stars. And you can see already by doing the minimum on the stars, they're a lot smaller. Now from here, I just create another layer. I can adjust this layer here. And it doesn't affect the stars. And we can boost, mess with our nebulosity without affecting the stars behind at all, which is really cool. So what would happen here? I just went ahead and same thing, curve up, S, now our stars are really bloated, plus there's crap ton of stars. The difference, that and that. Huge difference. So it's easy to remove the stars with either StarXTerminator or Starnet. And then it's easy to make a star mask from your starless layer with the stretch layer that you use to make your starless layer. And then it's easy to add the stars back on top. While editing the stars, editing the nebulosity layer separately. And that will end this video.